Welcome back. This is a little bit different than what I normally create for my channel, but I thought I'd try something a little different this week. I want to introduce more talking videos on my channel. For those of you who are new, I create mostly no talking content, writing content, study with me's, all that kind of stuff. So if you're interested in that, check out the other videos on my channel. But this week I wanted to do some puzzle piece sorting. I'm a huge puzzle lover. I just picked up this lovely Hershey puzzle. It has all sorts of chocolates in it. I love a good puzzle. This one's 1,000 pieces, so it's pretty big. Not going to do any solving today, just puzzle piece sorting. Let's crack this bad boy open and begin. The box has some seals on it, so let's get some peel sounds in, because why not? Here's something for your right ear to enjoy. Thank you. sometimes you're trying to figure out the small little details in a puzzle, like the little crinkles on the Hershey's Kiss wrappers here, and it's so nice to see them close up. So know what kind of candy you guys like. Hershey's or not, just any type of candy. Do you, for my friends that live outside of the United States, because I'm from the US, I'm curious, what kinds of candy do you have that we don't have that you just completely recommend? I feel like I just keep finding more and more red pieces. Like a surprising amount of red pieces. Thank you. see those. Those like flew out of frame there. Yep, there they are. I'm gonna put them back over here so they don't get lost. Push that in a little bit. I don't know about you, but I could absolutely just sit down and crank out a puzzle all day. Like, I could do it 8-10 hours straight just solving a puzzle. I love things like puzzles, crossword puzzles, those, what are they called, where you like, you fill in the little tiles. I have an app, but I know you can get like paper versions too. It's kind of like a crossword puzzle, but you're creating a picture. I think they're called nanograms or nonograms. N-O-N-O-G-R-A-M-S or nano. I'm not 100% sure, but those are super fun and super rewarding too, kind of like a puzzle, because you get a, I hope that wasn't an edge piece, because I don't see my mind. I just dropped a piece on this pile randomly. But yeah, those are super satisfying, like a puzzle, because there's a nice picture at the end that you're making, and it kind of helps you solve it, unlike a crossword puzzle where you need to know certain, you need to kind of really think on certain clues. You can kind of use the picture and a nanogram to help you solve it. But yeah, I think it's much easier to do like those kind of puzzles, those picture puzzles, nanograms, on your phone, because I've tried to do puzzle apps on my phone and the pieces are just like everywhere. I think it would be probably a little easier with an iPad or like on the computer, but that's not really on the go. I guess iPad's more on the go. But still, I feel like you're just, if especially if you're, you know, staring at a screen that long and like moving pieces around with your finger, every time I've tried to do a puzzle like digitally, it's just not been a fun experience. So I much prefer solving a real traditional puzzle. I mentioned previously that I did a ton of puzzles growing up as a kid. And we still have all the puzzles I solved as a child at my childhood home. Doesn't really use them much, so I'd love to take them or borrow them and solve them again, just because I feel like it'd be super nostalgic. I'm kind of collecting puzzles on my own. It's coming along. Puzzles aren't really that expensive. I just don't think to buy them that often, and I don't have a solid place to look for puzzles, so if you guys have any recommendations, I usually either like buy some at Target as an impulse buy when I'm over in like the game section, because I like to find fun games for whenever I'm hosting people. Sometimes I'll see a puzzle that'll catch my eye, like I found this puzzle a couple of months ago, and oh my god, I thought it was going to be a quick solve. I was like out of town visiting family, so it wasn't at like a local Target, but you know, I wanted to get a smaller puzzle just to keep the mess of puzzle pieces to a minimum. Plus the family I was visiting had cats, and if you have cats, you know how they get around a puzzle. I usually have to wait until mine are, you know, taking a solid nap, because they'll just knock this whole thing off the table. So I tried to find a puzzle with, you know, 500 or less pieces, and this one puzzle really caught my eye. It was literally a holographic puzzle, like super shiny, but from the box it didn't look like crazy shiny, like so much so that it was gonna like reflect up at you and like completely distort your view of the puzzle, but it ended up being that way. I've never solved a puzzle like that, where it's so shiny that you kind of have to like look around at it from all angles, because the colors change. It was like iridescent. It was a really beautiful puzzle, oh my goodness. But a puzzle that I thought was gonna take me a day to complete while visiting family ended up taking me weeks. And obviously, you know, I had to work when I got back. So I basically had the weekends to do this puzzle, and it took so long. I don't know if I'd do a puzzle like that again. It was definitely very challenging, and I love a good challenge when it comes to puzzles. I always usually go for 1,000 pieces or more. Just hopping into a bit. my cats actually knows how to open doors, which is just so fun. Yeah, that was kind of like a peely snout. But yeah, he knows how to open doors. That's a lot of fun, especially when you're trying to sleep and your cat decides that they're hungry and they open up the door where their food is stored. Try to break in. Luckily, I have their food in a pretty airtight, sealed container, so they haven't been able to get into that yet, but I'm not just a crazy cat lady, I promise. I'm not even a cat person. I'm like a huge animal lover. I love every single animal. And I do have a dog. Hoping to get another dog soon. I just love all the animals. happened before. That's kind of frustrating to take those guys back up. Oh my god. Just as we were talking about it, there's the last corner. Nice. Well, that was really satisfying. Speak it into existence.
Getting dark out, so I'm probably going to package these pieces.
boxes up and little baggies for next time. Thank you guys so much for making it all the way to the end of the video. That means so much to me.